This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Notable sites protesting: Boing Boing, Cheezburger, Craigslist, Flickr, Google, Internet Archive, Mojang, Mozilla, Reddit, Techdirt, Tumblr, Twitter, Wikipedia, WordPress, xkcd, Major Bill Supporters, Motion Picture Association of America, Recording Industry Association of America, Entertainment Software Association. A screenshot of the English Wikipedia landing page, symbolically its only page during the blackout on January 18, 2012. On January 18, 2012, a series of coordinated protests occurred against two proposed laws in the United States Congress, the Stop Online Piracy Act SOPA and the Protect IP Act PIPA. These followed smaller protests in late 2011. Protests were based on concerns that the bills, intended to provide more robust responses to copyright infringement, colloquially known as piracy arising outside the United States, contained measures that could possibly infringe online freedom of speech, websites, and internet communities. Protesters also argued that there were insufficient safeguards in place to protect sites based upon user-generated content. The move to a formal protest was initiated when some websites, including Reddit and the English Wikipedia, considered temporarily closing their content and redirecting users to a message opposing the proposed legislation. Others, such as Google, Mozilla, and Flickr, soon featured protests against the act. Some shut down completely, while others kept some or all of their content accessible. According to protest organizer Fight for the Future, over 115,000 websites joined the internet protest. In addition to the online protests, there were simultaneous physical demonstrations in several U.S. cities, including New York City, San Francisco and Seattle, and separately during December 2011 a mass boycott of then-supporter GoDaddy. The protests were reported globally. The January protest, initially planned to coincide with the first SOPA hearing of the year, drew publicity and reaction days prior to the action. The White House issued a statement that it would not support legislation that reduces freedom of expression, increases cybersecurity risk, or undermines the dynamic, innovative global internet. On January 18 itself, more than 8 million people looked up their representative on Wikipedia, 3 million people emailed Congress to express opposition to the bills, more than 1 million messages were sent to Congress through the Electronic Frontier Foundation, a petition at Google recorded over 45 million signatures, Twitter recorded at least 24 million SOPA-related tweets, and lawmakers collected more than 14 million names, more than 10 million of them voters, who contacted them to protest the bills during and after the January protest. A number of politicians who had previously supported the bills expressed concerns with the proposals in their existing form, while others withdrew their support entirely. Internationally, scathing criticism of the bills was voiced from World Wide Web inventor Sir Tim Berners-Lee, as well as the European Commissioner for the Digital Agenda. Some observers were critical of the tactics used. The Boston Herald described the service withdrawals as evidence of how very powerful these cyber bullies can be. Motion Picture Association of America Chairman Chris Dodd stated that the coordinated shutdown was an abuse of power given the freedoms these companies enjoy in the marketplace today. Others, such as the New York Times, saw the protests as a political coming of age for the tech industry. By January 20, 2012, the political environment regarding both bills had shifted significantly. The bills were removed from further voting, ostensibly to be revised to take into consideration the issues raised, but according to the New York Times, probably shelved following a flight away from the bill. Opposers noted the bills had been indefinitely postponed, but cautioned they were not dead and would return. Main pages of the Japanese Wikipedia and the Dutch Wikipedia on January 18, expressing support for the English Wikipedia protest. Contents 1 Background 11 Background to Bills 12 Legislative and Protest Timeline 2 Protests of November 16, 2011 American Censorship Day 3 December 2011 Boycott of GoDaddy 4 Protests of January 18, 2012 41 Protesters 411 Wikimedia Community 412 Other Websites 413 Physical Demonstrations 42 Reaction 421 Pre-Protest 422 January 18 423 Post-Protest 4231 International Responses 5 Related Protests 6 Legislative Impact and Aftermath 7 Other Proposed Laws 8 See also 9 References 10 Bibliography 11 External Links Links Background Main articles, Protect IP Act and Stop Online Piracy Act. Background to bills: the Stop Online Piracy Act SOPA and the Protect IP Act PIPA are bills that were introduced into the United States House of Representatives and the United States Senate in the last quarter of 2011. Both are responses to the problem of enforcement of U.S. laws against websites outside U.S. jurisdiction, while the Digital Millennium Copyright Act DMCA and other existing laws have generally been considered effective against illegal content or activities on U.S.-based sites. Action is more difficult against overseas websites. SOPA and PIPA propose to rectify this by cutting off infringing sites from their U.S.-based funding, particularly advertising, payment processors, appearances on search engines, and visibility on web browsers. Instead, major providers of all these services are predominantly U.S.-based. Notably, the provisions also involved modifying the DNS system, a crucial service that underpins the entire internet and allows computers to locate each other reliably around the world. Supporters included, but were not limited to, media companies and industry associations such as the Motion Picture Association of America, the Recording Industry Association of America, and the Entertainment Software Association. Supporters generally identified a need to have more effective laws to combat the illegal domestic sales of products and services, the counterfeiting and sale of products such as prescription drugs, athletic shoes, and cosmetics, and worldwide copyright infringing activities which were problematic to prevent inasmuch as they originated outside the United States. Those opposed included a mixture of technology and internet firms and associations, content creators such as the Wikipedia community, free software authors, free speech organizations, lawmakers, and other websites and organizations, as well as members of the public using their services. They generally identified two main areas of severe side effects: one, effects on internet websites, community and user-generated content, and two, effects on critically fundamental internet architecture and security. Effects on websites, web communities, and user-generated content: the scope, language, definitions, procedures, remedies, and provision for immunity following wrongful allegations was seen as insufficiently narrow and well-defined. Legal analysts suggested that draconian court orders could be obtained without undue difficulty to take down an entire site, without dialogue or notification, due process, or liability for compensation if incorrect, even if the site were legitimate. Perceived consequences included serious undermining of free speech on the internet, devastation of the internet's communities, and widespread closure and chilling of websites, particularly those including user-created content or organizations such as libraries providing reference information. Observers also noted the laws could be used strategically against legitimate competitors or during elections. Effects on critical internet architecture: technical experts testified that the proposed DNS measures conflicted with the fundamental basis of the internet and would break ongoing attempts to make the net more secure against malicious use. Google's policy director, Bob Boorstin, stated that a site like YouTube supporting user-generated content would just go dark immediately to comply with the legislation. Tumblr, one of the first websites active in grassroots activism against the bills, added a feature that censored its website on November 16, 2011, and the social media aggregator Reddit also became deeply involved. Legislative and protest timeline: on November 16, 2011, a first hearing by the U.S. House Judiciary Committee was marked by online protests involving blackened website banners, popularly described as American Censorship Day. On December 15, 2011, the first House Judiciary Committee markup hearing took place for SOPA. Prior to its eventual move to the House floor during the markup session, several proposed amendments to address technological and other concerns were defeated. The markup process was put on hold to be resumed after the new year. Around this time, numerous websites began displaying banners and messages promoting their readerships to contact Congress to stop the progress of the bill, and some websites began to discuss or endorse a possible internet blackout before any vote on SOPA in the House. As a means of further protest, Reddit was the first major site to announce an internet blackout for January 18, 2012, and several other sites shortly followed, coordinating actions for that day. A notable political response to the November 2011 protests was the outlining in early December of a bipartisan third, alternative bill with the support of technology companies such as Google and Facebook, which unusually had been posted on the internet internet to allow public comment and suggestions in light of the widespread protests related to the SOPA and PIPA bills. It was formally introduced as the Online Protection and Enforcement of Digital Trade Act Open in the Senate on December 17 by Senator Ron Wyden and in the House on January 18 by Representative Daryl Issa. It proposed placing enforcement in the hands of the United States International Trade Commission, keeping provisions that targeted payments and advertising for infringing websites, and tightly targeted wording to avoid many other key areas of concern with SOPA and PIPA. Online discussions of a blackout and concerns over the bills continued unabated after the markup hearing and increased in prominence on January 11. Senator Patrick Leahy, the main sponsor for PIPA, said of the DNS filtering provision, "I will therefore propose that the positive and negative effects of this provision be studied before implemented," reported by some papers as removal of those provisions. Opposers deemed this a tactical withdrawal, allowing reintroduction at a later stage and ignoring other concerns as well as provisions in PIPA, and evidence that the bill had not been understood or checked by its own creators, and that proposals for a blackout were gaining impact. Momentum for the protests continued unchanged since the bills had merely been postponed, and due to their other contentious provisions. Mozilla's SOPA protest, displayed here in Firefox, used censor bars as an ironic graphic device. Protests of November 16, 2011, American Censorship Day. This section needs expansion. You can help by adding to it January 2012. On November 16, 2011, SOPA was discussed by the U.S. House Committee on the Judiciary. Tumblr, Mozilla, Techdirt, and the Center for Democracy and Technology were among many internet companies who protested by participating in American Censorship Day, by displaying black banners over their site logos with the words "Stop Censorship." December 2011 boycott of GoDaddy. On December 22, 2011, users at Reddit proposed a boycott and a public day for switching away from then-SOPA supporter GoDaddy, the largest ICANN-accredited registrar in the world, known as Move Your Domain Day. The date was later set as December 29, 2011. Popular websites that moved domains included Imgur, the Wikimedia Foundation, and Cheezburger, which stated it would remove over 1,000 domains from GoDaddy if they continued their support of SOPA. On December 23, GoDaddy withdrew its support for SOPA, releasing a statement saying, "GoDaddy will support it when and if the internet community supports it." CEO Warren Adelman stated when asked that he couldn't commit to changing GoDaddy's position on the record in Congress, but said, "I'll take that back to our legislative guys, but I agree that's an important step." When pressed, he said, "We're going to step back and let others take leadership roles." Further outrage was due to the fact that many internet sites would be subject to shutdowns under SOPA, but GoDaddy is in a narrow class of exempted businesses that would have immunity, whereas many other domain operators would not. On December 26, 2011, a Google bomb was started against GoDaddy to remove them from the number one place on Google for the term "domain registration" in retaliation for supporting SOPA. This was then disseminated through Hacker News. Reddit users noted that by December 22, 2011, SOPA supporters were discovering the backlash that could arise from ignoring social media users. Reports up to December 29 described GoDaddy as hemorrhaging customers. On December 25, 2011, Christmas Day, GoDaddy lost a net 16,191 domains as a result of the boycott. However, on December 29 itself, GoDaddy gained a net of 20,748 domains, twice as many as it lost that day, attributed by Techdirt to a number of causes, in particular customers having moved early, and an appeased customer response to their change of position over SOPA. Protests of January 18, 2012. Protesters. Wikimedia Community. Play Media. The staff at the Wikimedia Foundation. The moment the blackout happened on December 10, 2011, Wikipedia co-founder Jimmy Wales drew attention to concerns over SOPA, which he described as a much worse law than the DDL Intercettazioni wiretapping bill in Italy some months earlier, which was being fast-tracked through the United States Congress under a misleading title. He stated he was attending high-level meetings on this, and wanted to gauge the sense of the English Wikipedia community on the issue, and specifically on the question of a blackout similar to that held successfully in October 2011 by Italian Wikipedia editors over the proposed media censorship law in that country. "I thought this would be a good time to take a quick reading of the community feeling on this issue. To be clear, this is not a vote on whether or not to have a strike. This is merely a straw poll to indicate overall interest. If this poll is firmly opposed, then I'll know that now. But even if this poll is firmly in support, we'd obviously go through a much longer process to get some kind of consensus around parameters, triggers, and timing." Following initial informal discussions which resulted in a positive response, a formal consultation titled SOPA Initiative was opened by the community to consider specific proposals and preferred options. These included matters such as location United States only or worldwide, and whether content should be disabled completely or still accessible after a click-through page eventually. The discussion led to a decision strongly in favor of a 24-hour global blackout of the site on January 18, disabling normal reading and editing functions. Affirmed in a vote of approximately 1,800 editors, the blocking action was purposely not complete. Users could access Wikipedia content from the mobile interface or mirror sites, or if they disabled JavaScript or other web browser functions within hours of the start of the blackout. Many websites posted instructions for disabling the banner by altering URLs, using browser add-ons such as AdBlock Plus or GreaseMonkey, or interrupting the page from loading completely. The vote formally affected the English Wikipedia only. Other language editions and Wikimedia projects were left free to decide whether to hold their own protests given the potential worldwide impact of the legislation, with technical support on offer from the foundation. The editor communities of at least 30 other sister projects chose to do so on January 17, 2012. Jimmy Wales affirmed the results of the community's decision and that the Wikimedia Foundation, which hosts the English Wikipedia website, would support the community's decision. He called for a public uprising against the proposed legislation, which critics fear would threaten free speech. He added that factors such as funding or donations had not been part of the community's considerations, but the matter had arisen as a principled stand from the community, and that in his view, our best long-term prospect for Wikipedia in terms of our survival depends on us being principled. He commented on editors' reasons for the decision. Free speech includes the right to not speak. We are a community of volunteers. We have written this thing that we believe to be a gift to the world. We don't charge people for it. It's freely available to anybody who wants to use it. We are a charity, and I think it's important for people to realize that the ability of our community to come together and give this kind of gift to the world depends on a certain legal infrastructure that makes it possible for people to share knowledge freely, that the First Amendment is incredibly important in terms of the creation of this kind of thing. Wikimedia Executive Director Sue Gardner posted an announcement of the foundation's support for the blackout proposal on Wikimedia's blog. The post received over 7,000 responses from the general public within the first 24 hours of its posting. The blackout was to run for 24 hours starting at 5 o'clock Coordinated Universal Time, midnight Eastern Standard Time on January 18. Despite the support of those polled for the action, a small number of Wikipedia editors blacked out their own user profile pages or resigned their administrative positions in protest of the blackout. One editor stated his main concern is that it puts the organization in the role of advocacy, and that's a slippery slope. Other websites, according to protest organizer Fight for the Future, more than 115,000 websites participated in the protest, including Google and Wikipedia. Websites that participated in the blackout included Cheezburger, Craigslist, Boing Boing, A Softer World, Cake Rex, Cyanide. The specially designed logo took readers to an informational page about the bills, and the opportunity to sign a petition to be sent to Congress stating their concerns. The Mozilla Foundation's default page was blacked out with links included onto how to contact one's elected representatives. Google placed a censor bar over their normal logo, which when clicked took visitors to pages with information on SOPA and PIPA. Sites like the Creative Commons provided a black banner and additional information to their visitors. Many sites, like the Free Software Foundation, blacked out their pages and directly encouraged viewers to take action. The Mozilla Foundation altered the default start page of their Firefox web browser, blacking it out and providing links with more information on the SOPA, PIPA bills and the opposition to them, and to allow users to email their congressional representatives. TV Tropes posted black bars atop the web page with the message, "Stop SOPA." Mojang's best-selling game Minecraft made a splash text that said, "SOPA means loser" in Swedish. A site called the Spoonie Experiment, known for a cute robot mascot called Burton, changed the homepage into a more nightmarish version, involving a nightmarish version of Burton and the words "The Spoonie Experiment" replaced by red text proclaiming "The experiment is over," signifying the proposed death of several websites. Wired Magazine's online site used JavaScript to place black bars on most of the text on their page, as if the text was redacted. Outside of their key article regarding SOPA, PIPA, readers could remove the bars with a mouse click. The photo-sharing website Flickr created the ability for a registered user to censor an unlimited number up from an initial limit of 10 of photos as demonstration of how SOPA, PIPA regulation would affect the site, the user-selected photographs were grayed out, and included informational text. 4chan ran a banner and censored posts by users on all image boards, which could be viewed by hovering over them. StumbleUpon added numerous links to anti-SOPA, PIPA websites. A video was circulated by the League for Gamers, founded by Mark Kern and supported by ScrewAttack, Extra Credits, and Loading ReadyRun, protesting the Entertainment Software Association's support of SOPA by gathering support to boycott the ESA's popular E3 convention. Physical demonstrations. This section needs expansion. You can help by adding to it. January 2012 anti-SOPA, PIPA protesters in New York City, in coordination with the internet blackout. In addition to the online blackouts, protests in cities such as New York City, San Francisco, and Seattle were held on January 18 to raise awareness of the two bills. A series of pickets against the bills were held at the U.S. Embassy in Moscow. Two picketers were arrested. Reaction pre-protest. The announcement of the blackout was reported worldwide. Media that covered the story included ABC Australia, CBC, BBC, Der Spiegel, Le Figaro, Le Monde, Liberation, Fox News, The Guardian, Manafin, News Limited, Sky News, The Age, The Hindu, The New York Times, Taipei Times, The Washington Post, The Wall Street Journal, and The Times of India. Several media organizations, including The Washington Post, The Guardian, and NPR, encouraged a crowdsourcing solution for those left searching for answers during the Wikipedia blackout by inviting users to ask questions on Twitter using the hashtag AltWiki. An executive of the Motion Picture Association of America MPAA dubbed the blackout plan an example of the gimmicks and distortion that inflamed passions while failing to solve the problem of copyright infringement by draw people away from trying to resolve what is a real problem, which is that foreigners continue to steal the hard work of Americans. Former U.S. Senator and MPAA Director Chris Dodd stated that the coordinated shutdown was also an abuse of power given the freedoms these companies enjoy in the marketplace today. Dick Costolo, CEO of social networking site Twitter, rejected calls for Twitter to join the protest, tweeting that losing a global business in reaction to single-issue national politics is foolish. Originally, some thought Costolo referred to all of the blackout movements on January 18, but afterwards clarified that he was referring to a hypothetical blackout of Twitter, and that he was supportive of the Wikipedia blackout itself. The sponsor of the bill, Representative Lamar S. Smith, called the blackout a publicity stunt, and stated with reference to Wikipedia that it is ironic a website dedicated to providing information is spreading misinformation about the Stop Online Piracy Act. On January 17, 2012, in response to growing concerns over PIPA and SOPA, the White House stated that it will not support legislation that reduces freedom of expression, increases cybersecurity risk, or undermines the dynamic, innovative global internet. SOPA, PIPA tweet levels, 3 days to 2,300. January 18, the Wikimedia Foundation reported that there were over 162 million visits to the blacked-out version of Wikipedia during the 24-hour period, with at least 8 million uses of the site's front page to look up contact information for their U.S. congressional representatives. The usage of Wikipedia's front page increased enormously during the blackout, with 17,535,733 page views recorded, compared with 4,873,300 on the previous day. A petition created and linked to by Google recorded over 45 million signatures, while the Electronic Frontier Foundation reported that more than 1 million email messages were sent to congressmen through their site during the blackout. MSNBC reported that over 24 million Twitter messages about SOPA, PIPA, and the blackouts were made during a 16-hour period on January 18. This included Facebook founder Mark Zuckerberg, who had not used the service since 2009, to encourage his followers to contact their congressman. Sen. Ron Wyden, D.O.R., a key opponent of the bills, said that lawmakers had collected more than 14 million names, more than 10 million of them voters, to protest the legislation. Time reported that before the day had ended, the political dominoes began to fall, then trickle turned into flood. It named 10 senators who had announced their switch to opposing the bills and stated that nearly twice that many House members had done so during the blackout. Libraries at several universities used the outage to remind students. that the traditional paper encyclopedias were available for research students who grew up turning to the internet to look up information were encouraged to visit the library as an alternative source of information on Twitter. A joke hashtag #FactsWithoutWikipedia trended with users posting humorous fake facts startled internet users frustrated or angry at their loss of Wikipedia for the day used Twitter as an outlet. Politicians likewise turned to Twitter when overwhelmed by the public communications flood in support of the blackout. CTV News in Canada published a survival guide for getting around the blackout on their national website, citing Wikipedia as the answer to burning questions such as are chinchillas rodents and what does rickrolling mean. The guide provided detailed instructions on how to circumvent the ban and access the English Wikipedia during the protest. CTV referred to the protest as a date that will live in ignorance. Creative America, a coalition representing movie studios, entertainment unions, and television networks, used the blackout to prompt those affected by it to enjoy other forms of entertainment in place of their normal internet activities. Such ads appeared at Times Square in New York City and on various websites post-protest. Play Media. Eric Mahler of the Wikimedia Foundation talking about the blackout at the opening of the San Francisco Wikipedia hackathon 2 days after the blackout. The impact of the coordinated action was generally considered to be significant. Yochai Benkler of the Berkman Center for Internet. Newspaper editorials had mixed views. The Boston Herald called the protest a hissy fit by internet powerhouses, saying, within hours of the online protest, political supporters of the bill began dropping like flies, thus proving how very powerful these cyber bullies can be. The New York Times described the protest as noted, but as a brief inconvenience, and, as well, offered an opinion about the protest and possible accomplishments. BBC News technology writer Rory Sellin-Jones was of the opinion that the blackout achieved its objectives but possibly at some cost to Wikipedia's reputation. Bill Keller was of the view that Jimmy Wales assumed a higher profile as a combatant for the tech industry supplied an aura of credibility to a libertarian alliance that ranged from the money-farming megatrons of Google to the hacker anarchists of Anonymous. Wikipedia editing levels before, during, and after the blackout. Media columnist David Carr wrote in the New York Times that there were two lessons, one being that people who don't understand the web should not try to re-engineer it, and the other that while businesses generally prize their relations with their customers, in the struggle between media and technology companies, the latter have a much more chronic, i.e. ongoing, intimate relationship with consumers and would more likely prevail. Motion Picture Association of America chairman Chris Dodd admitted that the content industry had lost the public relations battle with the internet industry, adding that "we've got an opponent who has the capacity to reach millions of people with a click of a mouse and there's no fact checker, they can say whatever they want." Dodd called for Hollywood and Silicon Valley to work out a compromise on the legislation, but was also criticized for a statement on Fox News to the effect that politicians would risk having campaign funding cut off if they did not support media industry proposals. The legal director of public interest group Public Knowledge was quoted on that organization's website as writing, "Threats like that are no way to conduct the serious, sober discussions needed to figure out exactly what ails the movie industry and to come up with solutions. It was Hollywood's arrogance in pushing bills through Congress without proper vetting that caused them to be withdrawn. These threats also are not helpful to figuring out what ails the industry and how to solve their issues," among other media industry reactions. Creative America was of the view that "have misidentified this issue as an issue about your internet. Your internet is being jeopardized. In fact, their business model is being asked to be subjected to regulation. They're misleading their huge base." Recording Industry Association of America President Kerry Sherman noted that the major television networks supported the legislation but, unlike Wikipedia and Google, did not use their platforms to try to shape public opinion. When Wikipedia and Google purport to be neutral sources of information that is not only not neutral but affirmatively incomplete and misleading, they are duping their users into accepting as truth what are merely self-serving political declarations. Rep. Lamar Smith, who sponsored SOPA, flatly stated in a commentary on Fox News that "this bill does not threaten the internet but it does threaten the profits generated by foreign criminals who target the U.S. market and willfully steal intellectual property by trafficking in counterfeit or pirated goods." While speaking on the Senate floor on January 23, Senator Leahy reiterated his objections to the protests, saying, "Websites like Wikipedia and YouTube would not be subject to the provisions of the bill that Wikipedia and some other websites decided to go dark on January 18 was their choice, self-imposed and was not caused by the legislation and could not be. It was disappointing that sites linked to descriptions of this legislation that were misleading and one cited the internet should be a place for discussion, for all to be heard and for different points of view to be expressed. That is how truth emerges and democracy is served." Last week, however, many were subjected to false and incendiary charges and sloganeering designed to inflame emotions. International responses. World Wide Web inventor Sir Tim Berners-Lee scathingly attacked the SOPA and PIPA legislation. Speaking at an industry event in Florida, he praised the protests by major sites for the attention they had drawn, and described the bills as a grave threat to the openness of the internet that had to be stopped. "The laws have been put together to allow an industry body to ask the government to turn off a website, and the government can make people turn off the site without trial. There are times when that could be very powerful and damaging, like before an election, and it is crossing a line, and we have to protect the internet as an open space. We have to respect it." 2 days later, Vice President of the European Commission and European Commissioner for the Digital Agenda Neelie Kroes described the bills as bad legislation that would threaten the basic foundation of the success of the web. She also said there should be safeguarding benefits of open net. "Speeding is illegal too, but you don't put speed bumps on the motorway," she said. Related protests. SOPA and PIPA protests were overlapped and followed by protests against ACTA, which has a similar sense. The ACTA treaty was signed by 22 member states in Europe and was expected to be signed before March 2012 by the other left: Cyprus, Estonia, Netherlands and Slovakia, and thus would have gained legal force for the whole European Union on February 11. More than 200 European cities took part in a widespread protest against ACTA. Although protests were held in Europe, the signing of ACTA was led by USA, Australia, Canada, South Korea, Japan, New Zealand, Morocco, and Singapore, which were first to sign the treaty at a ceremony on October 1, 2011, in Tokyo. However, the concerns of ACTA are much related and raised after the protests against SOPA and PIPA, which directed the public attention to bills and acts that may threaten internet and civic liberties. Legislative impact and aftermath. During the day of January 18, six of PIPA's sponsors in the Senate, including Marco Rubio, PIPA's co-sponsor, Orrin Hatch, Kelly Ayotte, Roy Blunt, John Boozman, and Mark Kirk, stated that they would withdraw their support for the bills. Several other congressmen issued statements critical of the current versions of both bills. By the following day, 18 of the 100 senators, including 11 of the original sponsors of the PIPA bill, had announced that they no longer supported PIPA. By one account, the shift in stated positions on SOPA, PIPA by members of Congress had gone overnight from 80 for and 31 against to 65 for and 101 against. An initial floor vote was scheduled for January 24, prior to the internet blackout, but following these responses, Senator Majority Leader Harry Reid announced that the vote will be postponed, urging the bill's main sponsor, Senator Patrick Leahy, to work out compromise in the bill to forge a balance between protecting Americans' intellectual property and maintaining openness and innovation on the internet. Similarly, the House Judiciary Subcommittee Chairman, Representative Lamar S. Smith, announced that further voting on SOPA would be placed on hold until there is wider agreement on a solution. Later, an updated The New York Times news story reported that the two bills were indefinitely shelved. House Committee on Oversight Chairman Daryl Issa commented that this unprecedented effort has turned the tide against a backroom lobbying effort by interests that aren't used to being told no, describing the events as a responsible and transparent exercise of freedom of speech. Opposers cautioned that although postponed, the bills were not dead and would return months after the protests. In July 2012, the New York Times summarized events as follows: Wikipedia went black to protest SOPA and more than 7 million people signed online petitions, many of which said the bills would break the internet. Congress, overwhelmed by the popular opposition, quickly backpedaled, leaving the legislation to die. The development of the electronic grassroots campaign has been the subject of academic analysis. Other proposed laws. According to the Electronic Frontier Foundation, SOPA and PIPA are really only the tip of the iceberg. The same forces behind these domestic U.S. laws have continued to both push for other states to pass similar domestic laws, as well as to secretly negotiate international Trade agreements that would force signatory nations to conform to the same legal standards. Examples cited by F include the Anti-Counterfeiting Trade Agreement ACTA, a pending international treaty signed by the United States in October 2011, is similar to SOPA on the 4th of July 2012. The European Parliament declined its consent, effectively rejecting it 478 votes to 39 and 165 abstentions. The Trans-Pacific Strategic Economic Partnership TPP IP terms controversy. Special 301 reports, a United States law mandating annual global copyright and IP law reports, explicitly to protect and act in favor of U.S. intellectual property owners against any other country's domestic or foreign policies or actions not conforming to United States positions. Threat of action under Special 301 has been used to insert U.S. lobbyist written legislation into other countries' laws. Examples considered similar to SOPA, PIPA by other analyses, Ireland's proposed law SI No. 337/2011, European Communities Electronic Communications Networks and Services Universal Service and Users Rights Regulations 2011 has been described by news media as Ireland's SOPA as a statutory instrument. No parliamentary vote is required to pass this into law. Russia's proposed law Duma Bill 89417-6, titled On Protection of Children from Information Harmful to Their Health and Development, has also been described as Russia's SOPA. Poorly defined, overly broad and unclear definitions of which sites are liable under its censorship provisions, and using a flawed blocking mechanism, the blocking of IP addresses, which can be shared by many sites. See also Freedom of Speech Portal, Internet Portal, Social Movements Portal, Politics Portal, Black World Wide Web Protest, the first major internet protest, internet activism, Italian Wikipedia blackout, list of organizations with official stances on the Stop Online Piracy Act, New Zealand internet blackout, Trans-Pacific Partnership, Trans-Pacific Partnership intellectual property provisions. References Carrot ABCD. Wortham, Jenna. 19 January 2012. Public outcry over anti-piracy bills began as grassroots grumbling. New York Times retrieved 21 January 2012. Carrot AB. Rupert Murdoch. SOPA attack rebuffed by Google. BBC News. 16 January 2012. Retrieved 17 January 2012. Digital Chief backs anti-SOPA protests. V3 retrieved 20 January 2012. Criminal penalties for doing their jobs. Carrot Sollier, Kirsten. November 16, 2011, American Censorship Day makes an online statement. The ticker, American Censorship Day makes an online statement. The ticker, Bloomberg. Retrieved 17 November 2011. Carrot, GoDaddy no longer supports SOPA. GoDaddy retrieved 23 December 2011. Carrot, GoDaddy boycott fizzles, twice as many domains transfer in as out. Techdirt. Wikipedia. Carrot Kerr, Dana. 19 January 2012. Mozilla reaches 40 million people in anti-SOPA campaign. CNET retrieved 20 January 2012. Novosti, Enriru. 18 January 2012. Retrieved 10 February 2012.